Hey guys, let's discuss another important topic, pre-oxygenation today. So first thing, what is pre-oxygenation? Pre-oxygenation is nothing but administration of oxygen prior to the induction of general anesthesia to increase the reserve in the patient's body. So why we want to increase the reserve in the body? To actually prevent or increase the safe apnea period during the intubation. Okay, to increase the safe apnea period during the intubation. So next question arises, what is safe apnea time? Safe apnea time is actually nothing but whenever we have induced that patient, the breathing has gone, that is cessation of the breathing. So the breathing has stopped, cessation of breathing, to the time until which saturation is actually maintained more than 90%. If the saturation falls less than 90%, then the patient has gone out of the safe apnea time. Okay, so the safe apnea time is nothing but cessation of the breathing to the saturation more than 90%. Okay, so today we are actually more interestingly focusing on because every day we are pre-oxygenating the patient. So you have to know how much time the patient is able to withstand pre-oxygenation and how much time you have to pre-oxygenate the patient to increase the safe apnea time. So that is I will be discussing today with that example, alveolar gas equation. Okay, so next, pre-oxygenation is actually included in the difficult RB society in, that is American Society of Anesthesiologists Task Force introduced difficult RB society in 2003. Every patient in which difficult RB is suspected, you have to adequately pre-oxygenate the patient, because in whichever RB we don't know, any RB, even the easy RB can, ASA 1-2 patients can handle with difficult RB, can't intubate, can't ventilate situation. So every patient had to be pre-oxygenated adequately, and pre-oxygenation before extubation is also recommended from 2012, because this incidence have been the reports shown that prior to extubation, if you pre-oxygenate the patient adequately with 100%, it will increase the reserve time in case of difficult RV, because if you want to re-intubate, you have some reserve time so that we can prepare adequately. Okay, and next is actually today pre-oxygenation, we will be seeing which are the methods to pre-oxygenate the patients. The methods is nothing but either we are replacing your tidal capacity breaths, tidal volume capacity breaths we are replacing, or we are giving actually your vital capacity breaths. Okay, how many vital capacity? 4 breaths in 30 seconds or 8 breaths in 60 seconds. Okay, so these, another is you know that most of the CPAP mode in obese patient it is useful, then your Thrive, then high frequency general ventilation or BiPAP, every methods has been used, but the most commonly used is actually replacing the vital capacity breath, 8 vital capacity breath in 60 seconds, and replacing tidal volume breath is actually superior compared to the 4 breath in 30 seconds technique. Okay, others are actually less commonly used method. Okay, next we have to know what is the end point of pre-oxygenation, because we will be oxygenating the patient with 100% FiO2, we will be oxygenating the patient. So what is the end point of this pre-oxygenation? The end point is nothing but you have to see in the ETO2 concentration. If the ETO2 concentration is more than 90% or end tidal nitrous oxide concentration which is less than 5%, means then the patient is adequately pre-oxygenated, and the time for the pre-oxygenation varies from individual to individual. So that today I will be discussing about that in detail with the help of alveolar gas equation. Okay, these are the main things. Next I will just give an example and describe the pre-oxygenation part well. Okay, you have the patient usually breathes oxygen in room air, 21% the patient is breathing well, and the alveoli is mainly made up of actually your nitrogen will be contributing to 76%. So the what is pre-oxygenation? Majorly you are actually increasing the oxygen flow and replacing this nitrogen, that is effective denitrogenation, effective denitrogenation to remove the excess nitrous and refill this nitrous with the oxygen, so that to increase the alveolar oxygen fraction, alveolar oxygen tension, alveolar fraction, thereby it increases the pulm, that is your partial pressure of oxygen in the blood, that is blood oxygen tension in turn, so that it can withstand desaturation for some more time. Okay, this is most important in special situations, because in patient with RSI, if you are doing rapid sequence induction, your time, your adequate time for the ventilation is, you are only in modified RSI you are doing ventilation, whereas in RSI you are not doing ventilation, so that they have only pre-oxygenation. Oxygenation is the most vital step in RSI, because the apnea period, it will be the time to desaturate will be very less. Okay, next are the other special population is pediatric patients. We have low functional reserve as well as low tidal volumes, low FRCs will be there, and they tend to desaturate very faster, and they have increased metabolism also. Metabolism, this oxygen consumption is also is increased in these patients, so they tend to desaturate very faster compared to the adult patient. Another is an obese patient. In obesity patients, you know that because of this obesity, there will be in supine position, there will be decreased functional reserve, so that they have low FRC will be there. So this can be actually this in this kind of situation, it can be minimized, and pre-oxygenation will be effective. Pre-oxygenation can be increased by head up 20 degree. Head up will help because it will make the lower zone, the dependent part zone of the lungs will be well recruited, and your reserve will be more in this kind of patients. Okay, but in pregnant patient, even head up also don't works, because of the uterine size, the intraabdominal pressure will increase, will push the diaphragm up, there will be reduced FRC. So in pregnant patient also, you will be doing RSI, so you have to be in cautious because they have low functional reserve. Okay, and in patient with sepsis, they have increased metabolic rate, and the cardiac output will be less, they will be on anatropic support, so the requirement will be more, so they also have less reserve, they also tend to desaturate at a very faster rate. This is a special situation in pre-oxygenation, you have to be in taken care. Okay, so the definition, in effective end-tidal oxygen in the alveoli more than 90%, and end-tidal nitrous concentration should be less than 5%. These are the main target points in pre-oxygenation. Okay, let's take another example of the pre-oxygenation. Well, in this video, I just breaking down into two parts, so that the video will be very short and you can go through very easily. Okay, if any doubts, just message me down so that I can be free to answer your queries. Okay, thank you guys.